Thank you. In the beginning, darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God hovered over the waters.
In the beginning,
God created. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And God said, "Let there be light."
In the Word was life, and that light was the light of all people.
God saw that the light was good.
The light shines in darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
And God said, "Let us create humanity in our image." So God created humanity in the image of God.
And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us.
I am the light of the world, says the Lord.
Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
Glory be to the Creator, and to the Christ, and to the Holy Spirit. Please be seated.
Ring out the bells that still can ring. Forget your perfect offering. There is a crack in everything. That's how the light gets in. These words, these profound words, were written by the late Leonard Cohen. And these words today give us hope. Because we live a life of uncertainty and imperfection, never knowing what will happen next. And so we gather tonight to find something timeless. We come together each year in this holiday season to find meaning, to find the elements of life that never change. Year after year, we hear the same words. In the beginning was the Word. These words, rather than being mundane, connect us to that which has been constant since the beginning of time. These words can draw us in to connect us to the strand of goodness and hope and peace that has always existed. We reach for this strand to steady us in these unsteady times. And let's be honest, many of us are feeling unsteady. And we remember that so often the world is unsteady. But in the midst of being unsure, we gather as this community. We celebrate the 275th anniversary of Moravian College this year, and we recognize that in the midst of the unknown, there are traditions and customs that allow us to connect to what is right in the world. And so on behalf of Moravian College, I welcome you to be part of the great tradition of Moravian College Vespers. And I invite you to listen for the joy beyond the words. Listen for the peace within the music. Reach for the hope in the light of the candle and ring out the bells. Because the cracks in our world, our lives, and ourselves are letting the light in. So ring out the bells that still can ring. Forget your perfect offering. There is a crack in everything. That's how the light gets in.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Here ends the reading.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them at the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born in this day the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom God favors." Here ends the reading of God's holy word.
A prayer for Christmas giving. Let us pray. That throughout this season, we fill our gift giving with generosity, making us aware of the gift we have to share with loved ones. That throughout this season, we deepen our sense of joy, making us ever grateful for the small gifts others bestow upon us. That throughout this season, we enlarge our capacity for compassion, making us mindful of how we might give to those in need of sustenance and consolation. Everlasting light, come into our hearts and homes this Christmas, making us people of joyful generosity and gratitude. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
Please stand. This is the message we have heard from God and declare to you. If we claim to have fellowship with God, yet walk in the darkness,
we do not live by the truth.
But if we walk in the light, as God is in the light,
we have fellowship with one another in Christ's name.
Lord, let now your servants depart in peace.
Here, challenged and changed, moved and inspired to ring out the bells that still can ring. Feel the blessing and the beauty of music that stirs our souls and warms our hearts so that the light of hope shines around us and within us and through us this holiday season and throughout the year. Go in peace. Amen.